Welcome to Strength of Materials and Six, whereby we are going to deal with the shell legs, which is the structural frameworks in Strength and Six. Now, when you look at the sketch there, we have example of a shell leg whereby they show you the backstay, they show you the where the load is, the base between the legs, and then the load overhang, the distance from the legs. And then also the length of the legs, right? Now, exercise 1.1 on the book of Hendrik T. Wiggins says that the base of the legs and the backstay of a shell leg form an isosceles triangle of which the base is 4 meters, and the distance between the legs and the other two sides are 6 meters each, meaning that we have a triangle first, then which has the dimensions for each. It's an isosceles triangle. Then the second statement says that the length of the legs are 8 meters and that of the backstay are 12 meters. Right. They want us to determine graphically the forces of all members if a load of 6 kN is lifted by the shell leg. So now the first part we are going to start with, it is that isosceles triangle. So, when you come to isosceles triangle, we say that when you look at that, what we have here, we say we have an isosceles triangle in which we are going to label each and every part of it. Like they say that the base is 4 meters and the other part is 6 meters. Now, when you look at it, if I take my shell leg over there, say, and my isosceles triangle, if I they say that the base here is 4 meters and then the other side here, meaning that it is 6 meters. So as we know from geometry, we know that if two sides are equal, meaning that their angles will also be equal, right? Now, what we do, the first plan, you have to make a plan. We start with the plane, then we come up with the method. When you talk about the plane, is whereby we are talking about the top view, and then the method is whereby we lift that that shell leg to have what our side view. Right. Then what we say that the first part steps of following. Of the steps of drawing the top view. The first part is we draw the baseline. When we draw the baseline, we say that if we have a baseline here, let's call that baseline. Let's call that baseline X and X1. We have that baseline XX, right? So we can draw it below on the page, just below in the page, because if we have to lift it up, right? Now, the second part is whereby we draw the vertical baseline on the vertical baseline a vertical line of a triangle vertically through the horizontal line. That means a name across in the middle and name the corners in the middle, right? But I'm saying that if I have that XX, which shows that I'm going to say that I'm going to draw my line there. My line there, because of this, is that the base is 4. When the base is 4, meaning that I have 2 here, I have 2 here. Meaning that, let me call this point D, and then this one point B, and then this one point C. Right. The next part there, draw the line 6 meters to the left side of the triangle, of the line or of the triangle, to show the triangle is towards the left, right. That means it's going to show that the point of the backstay. Meaning that what we do, we draw that line again, which is XX, and then we say that we have that base, which is D, and then that point B and that point C. Then we say we draw we measure 6 meters here from there to that. And then we measure another 6 meters there, from there to that. And then let's call this point A. Then If I have this triangle, that means I want to form that. That means I'm going to draw the true legs of the shell leg. So the true legs, they said, is 8 meters. So they said we label the every corner. Like I say that I have D, I have B, I have A, and then I have C. Right? So I'm going to draw the true legs is not 6 meters, they say it's 8 meters. The size of a triangle is the one which is 6 meters, it's 8 meters. Therefore, I'm going to measure 8 meters to the right, and then 8 meters from to that, and then therefore let me call this point O. Right. So because of I have this sketch, now I'm going to, which is a this XX1. It's SX, not XX1. It is also XX. This vision is the same as this vision. It depends on what scale I'm going to use. Right. Then I'm going to draw the base, another baseline on top. We are going to draw the to lift the shell leg up. That means you draw the baseline at the top. When you draw the baseline, and then we produce every point to that. When we produce the every point, like we say that this is point A, let it be our point A. This is the middle one, is point D, let it be our point D. And then this one is point O, let it be O1. Right. And then this one is D. Right. Then when we have that point A, point D, and then point C, we say we are going to take the compass, and then at point D and point C, we are going to draw the arc. That means that line here, it is XX2. It's a line on top of the top view, right? As we say that here at the bottom here, this is this part here is a top view. So that line here, it is the one that is going to show you the side view. Right, then we say that here we are going to make an arc between D and C. So when we make the arc, we make arc from D and point O, not point C, point O. Sorry for that mistake, and point O. Then we make an arc. So after making an arc, as they say that, they always tell us the distance of the big stay. They also tell you the distance of the backstay here. So when you go back there, let's look at what is our backstay. Right. I think our backstay, they say that is 8 meters, okay? It's 12 meters. When we draw the arc, we draw the backstay from point A to the arc. That means you're going to measure the distance from there until it reaches the arc. So if it is 12 meters, that distance from there to there, it should be 12. If any distance given, it will be, we must measure it, right? Then we say that when we measure it there, you can produce it to the top because of that line, when it goes to the top, it's still going to be part of the shelling. Then we say, let's draw the line. That's our line, it's our big stay, therefore that is our point A, that is our point D, that is our point O1. And then this distance from here to here is given. Then we can say that we join D with O. This one is point O from O1, is O from O1. It comes from the bottom here, it goes to the top there. So you see that side there, it's a side view. Now from that side view, what we have here, we say that let's draw the load line. The load line will be, according to, as they say, that the load is equal to 6 kilonewton. So you can say 2 centimeter is equal to 6 kilonewton, and then 1 centimeter, it is 3 kilonewton. Right, and then we draw them vertically, that line. So after we draw that line, then we say that we need to get the line which will be parallel to that, so that we want to produce point M. Point M, it is the one that M and N are the ones that was going to make a parallelogram here. We say that if this line like AO, you see there's a line at AO, we slide straight down to where the load is. And then when the load is there, that will give you the point M, right? Then we say that another line here, let's take another line there. There's the line on the blue ones. We slide it to the top there for that. This one will give you point N. That means I have the gap here. That means ON. ON, when you measure it, you can measure ON there. ON will give you the distance, the magnitude. Will give you the magnitude of the backstay. Right, then we are going to take that M, we draw the arc from M, and then we push it down to the top view. Because of the legs, we measure it from the top view. The backstay, we measure it from the side view. Right, then we say that this is the sketch that I'm having here. I still remember that I said that I have point A, I have point D, then I have point O, point O, right? Now I have point M, right? And O and N. Then I'm going to say that I'm going to produce point M to the top view, not the front view, and N, okay? So there's the arc from, I'm going to put my compass from D again and M, and then draw this line there, going down there. So when it goes down there, at this point here, it will give me the point M1, right? Right. Well, after giving me the point 1, then I can pin M1. I'm going to say that, let me draw the line parallel towards that. So this line will be moving to that one at this point whereby the legs combine with that line here. Let's call it that point R. And then I'm going to say this one to that one. This one will give us that point 2. So this distance and that distance will be equal. That means OR will be the same as OT, or RO will be the same as TO. It depends on how do you call it. So those are, when you measure that magnitude of it, will give you the magnitude of the legs. So the backstay, we measure it there, ON, what will be the backstay? That means the distance that you multiply, that is that distance multiply by 3 because of multiply by 2 because of, you make the scale of 2, right? And then this also, this one you can say that everything multiply by the scale. Let me say if it's not 2, let's say multiply by the scale, which is 2. That's 6, the number that you have divided by 6 there. And then we have, we say multiply by the scale, right? Now this is what we are looking for, which is so that the load shows everything there. That is the triangle at the back there. Thank you.